August the 8th, 2023. The catastrophic fire that decimated the township of Lahaina.
We gotta move! Let's go, let's go! Clear out, clear out!
With little warning, the fire tore through surrounding neighbourhoods of Lahaina, destroying everything in its path. The first of three reports released by fire chiefs stated a number of factors contributed to that dark day. The first fire was sparked when a live power line snapped and hit dry bush. Strong winds fueled the torrent of flames that eventually leaped from street to street.
Oh my gosh, look at the harbour.
In all, 101 people lost their lives that day. Almost a year on, and Lahaina is now going about its daily business as best it can. But there are open wounds visible everywhere. Most Fridays, Mia and husband Jay are here at the Lahaina Cannery Car Park at their food stall. Jay is a chef at a local school and Mia is a family success coach here in Lahaina. Both remember that fateful day.
It was about 2:30 and the fire didn't go crazy till about 3:30, 4 o'clock. So I was about to reach home and it was high winds at that time. So even we had a fire where I work, so they sent us home. So when I went home and they found out I had a fire on this side.
When the deadly fire hit, those who perished were unable to escape. Many were elderly.
It's just really unfortunate that it happened and it impacted so many people. Yeah, and so many lives that will not get back. My cousin's father had passed. We danced in a hula halau and we lost our guitarist. A lot of the elderly couldn't make it out.
It's just been under a year since the devastating fires destroyed parts of Lahaina. While this community rebuilds and recovers, here stands a memorial as a tribute to those who perished.
My mom actually made red and white ribbon lace about a month after it happened. Just sad all around. You know, it could have been prevented.
The residents here are still very affected by the tragedy and how it has changed lives here in Lahaina. Many feel that they have been taken advantage of.
It's still like a touchy subject for a lot of people and it affected just the living, the cost of living here, you know, went skyrocketed.
Locals in the community want the town to be rebuilt back to the old township when King Kamehameha once ruled, a time when Lahaina was surrounded by wetlands.
My hope is that the state and federal entities will listen to the people of Lahaina, right, and restore it to its natural habitat, that there won't be brown, dry mountainsides, that there'll be ulu groves, you know, to catch the water and restoring the water to the rightful places.
Lahaina's scars still show on the landscape nearly a year after the devastating fires. But from the ashes, new life is emerging and the rebuild is taking shape.
Lahaina was the first capital before Honolulu, and it's very sacred. So to be able to restore the historical and traditional activities that were down here, right? The cultural knowledge and history, it shouldn't be forgotten. Yeah, for the sake of development, you know, or tourism. They really need to look at the locals because without locals, there's no more Hawaiians.